At just 92 days old, Stable Diffusion XL Turbo, your time has come to an end. Yes, it's sad to announce, but Stable Diffusion XL Turbo has been replaced by Stable Diffusion XL Lightning. Released just last week by the parent company of TikTok, ByteDance, this brand new technology allows you to generate images with a Stable Diffusion XL model in as few as 1 to 8 steps, and the results are absolutely outstanding. So in this video, I'm going to be showing you where to get the files, how you can work it into your existing workflow with a Stable Diffusion XL model, and the types of applications that you can use to run it. Let's go ahead and dive in. Adding this cutting edge technology to your workflow is incredibly easy, and there's two ways that you can do this. You can either use a LoRA or a standalone model. Now, if you head over to Hugging Face, you can read all the details about this new technology, but if you just want to get the good stuff, head over to the files in the versions tab, and then you'll see all the relevant models and LoRAs to download there. This includes the 1, 2, 4, and 8 step variants. Now, if you want more creative results, then I suggest you head over to Civitai, where the creators behind the likes of Juggernaut XL, Dreamshaper XL, and countless others have already released models with this newly available Lightning capability. To generate images with the Stable Diffusion XL Lightning model, you're going to have to use either Comfy UI or Forge. As it stands today, Automatic 1111's web UI does not have full support for this model. So using Comfy UI and have it fired up here, I'm going to just go ahead and set the default workflow that comes with Comfy UI, and then just basically swap out to the default Stable Diffusion XL Lightning model that I downloaded from Hugging Face. Now, the important point here though is that you're going to want to make sure that you set the KSampler node to the correct variables. Once that's set, you're just going to go ahead and fire off your prompt and then see the results. And as you can see, in just 4 steps or roughly a couple of seconds, we now have a great looking images from Stable Diffusion XL Lightning. Now, using Stable Diffusion XL Lightning as a LoRA is fairly much the same. You're just gonna wanna go ahead and add a load LoRA node between the checkpoint and your prompts, and then go ahead and fire off everything just as you would in the standalone model. Again, you're gonna wanna make sure you set all those KSamplers to the correct value before you click that cue prompt button. But as you can see, the LoRA method will kind of degrade the image quality just a little bit. So you will always wanna go ahead and use a fine-tuned model when possible, whether it's from ByteDance or one that you might have downloaded from Civitai. Now, just as a quick note though, whenever you're using a fine-tuned model with Lightning capabilities, you have to make sure that you read the notes from the creator, because we found that some of the recommended settings weren't always the same as what we saw with ByteDance. So for example, Juggernaut XL recommends a resolution of 832 by 1216 and a sampler of DPM++ SDE, which is fundamentally different from the other Lightning model we demoed earlier. Now, if you want to play with Stable Diffusion XL Lightning and you don't have a GPU, or you just don't feel like waiting forever to download a model, you can actually head over to Hugging Face or fastsdxl.ai, where I have some links in the description, and you can actually generate images in, it's literally like 250 milliseconds, which is blazingly fast. So check that out if you want to go ahead and kind of play around with Stable Diffusion XL Lightning. So that's it. It's a really incredible model. I mean, the fact that it can generate images in just like seconds is, you know, it's really cool. So, you know, I'm curious to see on how you guys plan on using this model. I'm thinking there's probably gonna be a lot of video applications for this because it's such a fast generation speed, but I'd love to know, because I'm sure there's tons of real world use cases out there. So drop it in the comment section below. And if you like the video, don't forget to hit that thumbs up and also consider subscribing to the channel. Thanks so much for watching, guys, and I'll see you in the next one, and take care.